day, people. I am going to do another pour for you today in some paints that I've been trialing for a few months and using them on and off. They're an Australian brand paint called Byron. Some of them come a little bit thinner than global paints and some of them don't, but the colours are very vibrant. So I'm trialing these today, these brand, and today my pouring medium, no Floetrol today. I've just pre-mixed my 70% Elmer's glue oil with 30% water. Just give a really good shake and you add it to your paint slowly just to get the right, I don't measure anything, just add to the paint. Had lots of, I add to the paint until I just get the consistency for a particular pour. Different pours require different consistencies. This, what I'm doing today, is going to be the pour and swipe. But because I want the cells to stretch out and make a life of its own, I do it a little bit thinner, but I will show you the consistency. I add 2 to 4 drops, no more, of this Helmar silicone. You can get it off eBay. I got this picked up two yesterday from, but that one has lasted me nearly a year. So $6.99 Australian. So, but I just find that excellent. And like I say, don't add very much of it at all. If it's a smaller cup, maybe one blob or two, but definitely no more than 4. So I put a few blobs of that in my cup. As usual, I made these paints up actually probably 3 days ago, but because I got carried away with using the milk paints, they've just remained covered with a wet tea towel over them. And then they don't skin and they stay fine. And I just usually find that the pores that I do with the paint that I've pre-made up, as long as it's kept without skinning, just works beautifully for whatever reason. So these were all pre-made up with my pouring medium and the silicone in them. And I always stir the silicone in really well. So that's what I do. So I'm not sure if you can see the consistency. It's not real thick and it's not real thin, but this is purposely made this way for this canvas that I want to do today, because I want the cells that, well, you'll see at the end, it'll come into little clusters, but over leaving it overnight, they'll stretch right out. So, okay, I have turquoise, I have bright yellow, I have magenta, I have the Global's pearl white. A nice pearly white. I'm going to keep this as it. I've done this one a bit thicker because it is a metallic, so that's a little bit thicker. And the only colours I've used from Global are their gold. I've used metallic gold and bling gold. So, and then I have got, which were made up out of the Global paints, which was their blue, and then added the red, so it's made this crimson. And I have got a little bit of navy left from a previous pour. I may swipe in the navy. Yeah, I think I'll swipe in the navy today because there's only that bit left, so it's just to use it up. But anyway, I'll get down to the pour, get down to business. So as usual, wear gloves every time. I know sometimes you get carried away, take them off, but it's just sensible to wear your gloves. Can't fit all the whole canvas into this frame because it's a 61 centimeter by 61 centimeter canvas, which is a 24 by 24 inch canvas. So yeah, I can't fit it all. I'm not set up with anything professional. So Okay, what I will begin with is the crimson purpley colour. I am just going to, now I was debating on just doing one swipe all the way down, but I think I'm going to swipe from the centre out because it's a quite a big canvas. So it's my normal thing is just pour your paint in a snaky fashion. Just find that doing these kind of pours, pouring the paint separate over instead of doing a dirty pour, it just is, you've got less chance of your paints muddying, and so they cause, you know, the nice crisp cells, they don't look muddy. And like I said, I'm looking for a look that the cells actually separate and form a little life of their own. This is the magenta. Okay, nice and quiet here today. My husband's out the back today working on tiling our back patio. So pretty excited about that, to get that done for our Australian summer. So he's got 97 square meters of tiles to lay, poor fella. And there I am painting, but he told me that there was nothing I could do to help him, so who am I to argue? Did see somewhere, yeah, a blob. I'll just pick it out. Just not one that I'm not one that stresses over getting blobs and things in your paint. Just pick it out and move it. It's not a big problem. So this is the turquoise, Byron's turquoise. It's looking pretty dark colours at the moment, so I'm hoping, obviously, when I add the whites and the yellow to this, it'll brighten it up. I have done these colours before, down the line somewhere. Okay. My husband decides to use the drill. Sorry about that. I'll shut the door and see if it... I cannot do a paint pour and it be silent. Always something kicks off. He'll start to do the slashing, he'll start to do the mowing. And of course, yeah, you guys have to suffer these noises. Sorry about it. Well, that's brightened it up straight away. I'm pouring some of this metallic pearl that does look to be a lot of paint on. I might start tilting off a bit before I add, because I do want to get the gold in there. So I might start tilting off, so just to make sure my canvas is covered. Okay, as I said, this is quite a large canvas that I can't get in the all in the frame of the camera, so sorry about that. But just take it easy, just gently tilting. Okay, just a gentle tilt. Now, as I've said in every one of my videos, don't worry about your corners at this stage because they're easily fixed. So trying to tilt over your corners, you can lose like so much paint in the wrong direction if you just continually stressing about pouring over your corners, and it's no biggie. So, as I said, just take it slow, just tilting so you're covering your whole of your canvas with your paints. There's plenty on this particular canvas, so it's no worry about that. It is moving quite slowly, which is a good thing. So if it was obviously moving really quickly, paints would probably be too thin and show lots of holes sort of appearing where you see your canvas. Try and always tilt back to centre the paint again before you start tilting another direction. Yeah, just going to tilt some off down that end. As you can see, these Byron paints, like Global, are really vibrant. That's it. I'll tilt it all back to the center. Here we go. Okay, I think that's okay. So, as I said, I don't stress about the corners. What I'll do is with the paint I've just tilted off, I just get on my glove, drag some up, and just finger pop it on the over the bits where the canvas is missing the paint. So it's no big deal. Okay, just going around the back here, so it's disappearing for a minute, just to keep the canvas covered. So I can pour some of my paint over the corners, or you could pour if that's what you so desired, but not too worried about it at all at the minute. Just don't stress about covering your corners. So yeah, you can get some of your paint and put it over those corners. So just want to get some of this. In fact, I might only use the metallic gold. I just want to get a little bit in to give a bit of shine when the painting dries, and probably putting it on the top like this is more than likely not to disappear. And just taking your time here, just enjoy what you do, that's what we're doing it for. Okay, so that's that stage complete. And I obviously haven't used anywhere near all of those paints for this, because as I've explained before, I just make up whole cups of paints and then I just continue painting canvases until they're gone. I don't just make up a batch of paints for one canvas. So what I'm going to do here now is I'm going to, it's navy. And I'm going to, it's a dark navy, but it does dry looking navy and not black. So I'm going to pour down the center, not too much paint at all, just a line. I'd go back just carefully. So as you see, it's not much paint at all. I may need a little bit extra because this paint's got a stretch, but I'm just going to try the first wipe and see how we go. As usual, I just use one of these plastic file dividers. It has got the little, I just cut off that bit. Can cut off the end, but I just use this end to hold with. So when you're using these, they're obviously washable and reusable hundreds of times. They're nice and flexible, so you can, I just let my, the very tip, about a centimetre, drop into the paint, not the whole, no more than a centimetre, and just gradually draw the paint down with your file divider. So, okay, wipe your swipe tool off, which is my file divider, in between every, so you don't have, you're not dragging the other paint, you just drag in the swipe colour over your work. Yep, picked up some paint there from the next line, but never mind. Again, it's already getting some really cool little cells pop up. Who'd have thought we'd ever get excited about cells popping up? Oh my goodness. Such is life. Okay, go down again. Let's take it nice and steady. When you see it at this point in time, you think, ooh, how on earth is this going to turn out looking anything special? But that's when the magic happens, and it really does. So again, from the other side, just gently, no hurry. Just let your paint run off. Yep. Wipe your tool, your swipe tool in between each one. There you go. I didn't need any extra paint, did I? I thought that I'd need, because it's really, I think because you're doing it slowly, taking your time, and you just drop that half a centimetre of your, or centimetre of your file divider in, it seems to give a really good swipe cover over your whole of your work. Okay, well that's done. I'm just going to pop my swipe tool into the wash. I just soapy water gets it off beautifully, but obviously they're pretty cheap for I think 6 to 10 file dividers. You know, they're pretty cheap, so the best swipe tool, they really are. As you see, this is developing all on its own, but even more magic will happen when I torch it. So obviously some work you do, you might want to get to this point and leave it to do a, I've used this kind of swipe this way to do a reflections pour where you can allow it to dry. The only thing is you don't use as much paint on it, but you go through all the same process, allow it to dry. And you can either paint a city or hills, and then you've got like the Northern Lights or Southern Lights, whatever they call them, and their reflection on water, and that looks pretty cool in itself. So it's just ideas. Okay, I'm using my trusty gas butane torch. A lot of you may have the little brulee little torch, which is fine, but I think what you'd have to do is get a little bit closer to get the effect. Okay, sounds as though my torch is running out. It's not very okay. I'll do, as my granddaughter calls them, my jilly clusters. I get the direct and pop it just down, just holding on, just holding the torch flame, just as very little, because you don't want to set fire to your canvas. So these are what, yeah, my granddaughter calls my jilly clusters. I only get this effect, really, this particular effect, when I use the glue all and the glue all and water pouring medium. I don't get this effect when I use Floetrol, and some paints definitely don't. Not all paints go well with the glue all. The paints that I'm using, obviously the Byron is excellent. The Global is excellent. I use some other Burrows paints. I use Chrome Acrylic or an A2, and they all seem to go good with this, but I'm not sure what the Liquitex Basics or Golden, because I've never used any of those paints. So, okay, you see these gorgeous jilly clusters coming up everywhere. It does look pretty. Oh, gosh. I'm not sure if the camera's showing this, but they are just like, just popping up like gemstones, really gorgeous. Where you can see these smaller clusters of cells, doing the mix how I did it, with the consistency I did it, which is, obviously it's not too thick and not too thin. It's just like a pouring cream. I do it that particular consistency because where you're seeing all of these like this now, they all start to relax and stretch out into one another. The video I put up just on my art page yesterday of one that was dry, it looked nothing. It ended up looking like this when I finished the video, but then yesterday when it's all dry, it's all just, sort of gone into... Well, I'll tell you what, I'll show you. Just so in case some of you didn't see. The cells stretch. The cells have stretched, look. and gone, sort of created a little life of their own. There's no balloon kissing in this one, which I usually love to do, but it's just created a little life of all of its own. So love that effect. And I hope you do too. So I'm going to just leave this now to develop, and all of those spaces you see with the negative space in between, oh, sorry about this, the negative space in between, those cells will stretch out, and then that navy will just become an outline to all the cells. So this is definitely another gemstone pour. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. It's free. If you don't like what I've done today, just move on without negative comment. Thank you.